one fantasy game on the One Super app, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game. An overwhelming 71% of fans favouring a win for Meng Bo over Laura Ballin. We're on the ground early, which is where Ballin prefers to be, though Meng Bo does have a background in wrestling. So top position is where Meng Bo wants to be on the ground. Poses the guard as Ballin.
Watch out back of the head.
The Argentinian likes to choke out opponents. 5 wins by choke, 4 by rear naked choke. Doesn't fare well on the road. A 5th time competing outside of Argentina. 1-3 on the road to date for Laura Ballin. Has finished by sub in 3 of her last 4 losses. Got to be careful because Meng Bo possesses a lot of weapons and does have 5 submissions in 13 wins. If it gets to the feet, Meng Bo 3-0 in Muay Thai, 3 knockouts in 13 wins in mixed martial arts. Meng Bo, a very highly anticipated one debut. She'd been scheduled to make her debut here twice before, but both times it was delayed, resulting in that long layoff I spoke about earlier. But she says there'll be no ring rust tonight. I'm fully prepared. She's been waiting a long time as Laura Ballin has a very high guard on Meng Bo.
Ballin's trying to attack an arm, I think, on the right side. She's got a nice high guard. Now she's got that leg up above the right shoulder of Meng Bo. She's almost gated.
This crowd in Beijing allowed for Meng Bo. She will bring down the roof on the Cadillac Arena if she wins, especially if she wins by knockout or submission. Slings the legs a little. Confidence oozing out of every pore of Meng Bo. Slings the legs some more. Will she allow Ballin back to her feet?
Stop.
And indeed, referee does her that favor. Bo comes forward. Jack. Ballin. Produces a huge win for China here in Beijing.
Wow, what a right hand. An absolute hammer. Our current strawweight queen, Zhang Jingna, couldn't even finish Laura Ballin. It took her 5 rounds. Went to a decision. Meng Bo gets it done in the very first. Look at this right hand. Waves, boom, right on the chin.
I tell you what, folks, Age of Dragons in Beijing is producing a night of the most electrifying and fastest finishers in one championship history. What is that, Mitch? 3 matches, 3 finishers all in the first round. It has been amazing. Let's go to Tom Lau and make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Meng Bo!
The Cedar immediately, oh, dropped! Nastyukhin puts Rob Lucida to sleep. Rob Lucida comes in forward and just bingo with that left hook.
Your referee, Yuji Shimada, calls this fight after 6 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout in the red corner, Timofey Nastyukhin.
I bound out of their corners. Yustakio, the former world champion. Wakamatsu, a cagey character, full of tricks. You never know what Wakamatsu is going to throw. Yustakio, a brilliant wushu stylist. Look out for the fast hands. Look out for the side kicks. Look out for the spinning back fists on Jehei Yustakio.
One thing we know Wakamatsu is going to throw is that giant right hand he's got. Utilized it beautifully against Demetrius Johnson, against Danny Kingad. Nice and light on his feet, bouncing in and out. Jay Hayes nice and relaxed. There he goes, chopping at the legs now with that Wushu style sidekick.
Right hand right from Jay Hayes, and lethal left hand just missed the target for Yustakia. And his crowd on the edge of their seats expecting something extraordinary from Yustakia.
And his chin a little bit tucked there. You can see when he's moving backwards, he starts to pop that chin up. That right hand landed on the chin though.
High up on the ball to his feet here is Yuya Wakamatsu. Left hook right hand from Wakamatsu. Didn't have the distance. In overhand right from Yustakia going for the headache maker. Yustakia edging forward, gets out of the way, just evades the left hand of Wakamatsu. Body shot from Wakamatsu. Turning back kick from Yustakia. Now what the Wushu guys from Team Lakai will tend to do with that spinning back kick is to aim it towards the liver of the opponent. So just around below the right rib cage towards the stomach area, the large target that is only partly protected by the ribs, being the liver. Yustakia tip. This one's over. That is huge. We told you, you never know what Yuya Wakamatsu is going to throw. And Jay Yustakia did not see that coming.
Told you he was going to throw that right hand, though, Michael Savello.
Yeah, you did, Mitch. You called it.
Yuya Wakamatsu getting right back into it. Beautifully timed. Right hand comes over the top. Lands in a couple of punches. We got to see a look at again at that one. Yuya Wakamatsu bounces back perfectly. Check this out. Jay Hay gets caught with his chin up in the air. Yuya Wakamatsu comes right down the middle and connects with a beautiful right hand to get a big knockout of a very established veteran. That's a huge victory for Yuya Wakamatsu, Michael.
That is massive to knock out the former world champion in highlights real fashion. Yuya Wakamatsu over Jay Hay Yustakia. Not a good night for the Team Philippines so far here in Manila. Can they turn it around in our main card? Let's go to Tom Lau and make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 59 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Yuya Wakamatsu!
Yushin Okami coming out in the southpaw stance. Kiamrian was off nice and light on his feet in the orthodox stance. You can see Okami immediately starting to pressure him up, trying to get his back against the ropes.
Kiamrian expressed his respect for Okami. Let's see if that makes him a little bit more hesitant tonight.
Cameron Abbasov does tend to get overwhelmed by his opponent's experience like he did against Luis Sapo Santos, but he says this is his opportunity to make a name for himself. He already keeps that guard nice and high as Okami launches that high kick.
Swinging and looping right hand.
Just that nervous energy, that bouncing from Kiamrian Abbasov is usually a little bit more tentative.
Nice jab by Okami.
He's trying to get in there. He's trying to throw that jab out there. I like how he's utilizing those leg kicks to piece up the inside of the leg of Okami.
Okami's range is very good tonight.
Nice overhand right there landed by Kiamrian Abbasov as he throws the high kick, just barely skinning the whiskers of Okami.
Okami just circling away, staying composed.
He's throwing that inside leg kick. I like that shot there thrown by Abbasov. Attempting to attack the knee there. Oh, he shoots in. Nice little defense there so far from Abbasov. Let's see what Okami can do with the body block.
This is where Abbasov was successful in this last bout. He was able to overpower Aguilar Tani. Okami looks to be very strong in the clinch as well. Okami with the takedown landing and mount.
bad position for Kiamrian Abbasov to be in, as he was able to sweep that outside leg and land in a very dominant position in mount here. Abbasov's got to start moving. He can't allow Okami to slowly start working his way into mount.
Okami looking very composed. Abbasov has an overhook on the left arm.
That's him driving his hips down in mount. He's going to slowly and methodically work his way up, start doing softening him, Abbasov up.
Abbasov trying to hold Okami down. He needs to create space here, try to get his guard back.
It's those heavy hips of Okami. It's hard to buck off because he's got such heavy hips.
There you go.
He's able to do it. Good job.
Elevates Okami. Tries to elevate Okami with the butterfly hook on with his left leg there. Okami's looking to...
Yep. Good job by Kiamrian Abbasov to recover guard. Okami nice and tight. Kiamrian Abbasov does not want to be on the bottom here.
He does not.
He opens up his guard. Big right hand.
Abbasov with overhook on the left, right arm of Okami. He looks to just hold right now. He must have felt the power of Okami.
Yeah, he immediately shut down, tried to shut down that right hand because that big right hand is keeps coming. Okami's got heavy shots from that top position. He is a big welterweight. Okami's competed in a lot of different weight categories. I believe he's gone as high as light heavyweight in various organizations.
Abbasov using the stronger athlete in his matchups. Maybe he's not used to the strength advantage that Okami has over him. Okami looking to pass to the left side, pushes on the knee, passes right to half guard.
It was an easy pass as he stepped over that left leg, or the right leg rather, of Kiamrian Abbasov. Okami's got that underhook on the right side. He's able to keep Abbasov flat to the mat. Not allow Abbasov to scoot his hips out to the side and create movement.
Abbasov, there you go, doing a great job. One-to-one hip, retains half guard.
Okami is a grinder. He is 17-6 in bouts that go the distance, so he loves to wear on his opponents. He's just so dominant in all these positions. This is where he excels. This is what he wants to do. Okami shutting down the Russian wrestler. Almost able to get recover guard back, but Okami's trying to work past. Good job by Kiamrian Abbasov to recover guard.
Okami's staying very active, looking for the pass on the left side, but Abbasov as well, not giving anything up. Look for Okami to land a big shot to end the round.
He's throwing that right hand with some serious heat. That's why Kiamrian Abbasov is overhooking the right arm in that grounded position just to stop that big overhand right from coming.
That was a good round for Okami. Let's look at some of the action over here. Okami with the outside hook. Powers him through right into the mount. Secures the position. Okami here pops up to 1 foot. Controls with his left arm. Rolls the right hand down. Hard right hand that landed for Okami. The right hand from the top position has been the big shot for Okami today in that first round.
That's why Abbasov's trying to secure that hook on that side. He's trying to stall slightly just to avoid that big right hand because Okami is timing it beautifully. And the way that he's rolling over, Abbasov's trying to get a grip on that right hand, but Okami rolls over to throw that big right hand.
All right, ready?
Second round, Olivier Cost getting us started. Choke. Yushin Okami against Kiamrian Abbasov. Kiamrian Abbasov nice and light on his feet, trying to circle. I like how he's circling to the weak side of Kiamrian, of Okami. Nice little change of levels there by Okami to get the body lock. Oh, I like how he's utilizing those uppercuts to create a little separation.
Kiamrian Abbasov, unfazed by the takedown that Okami got off the clinch, goes back to the clinch himself. He believes that he has the advantage in the clinch, I believe.
Long punches. He just can't seem to keep coming when he throws out those punches, especially that left hand.
Abbasov, a lot more lighter on the feet this round. He wants to use his explosiveness. He knows that Okami is staying a little bit more sharp. Landing his straight punches, Abbasov is looking to loop over. There you go, loops over with a right hand. Lands on Okami. Okami is hurt. Abbasov following up with some left.
Cameron Abbasov swarming right now, dropping the ground. And the referee jumps in and stops it.
What a victory for Cameron Abbasov.
Cameron Abbasov lands the big right hand, hurts the Japanese legend as he crumbles. Cameron Abbasov jumps all over him and starts the grounded pound.
Cameron Abbasov made the adjustments in the second round, was light on his feet, utilized his explosiveness, and landed a right hook over the guard of Yushin Okami. What a performance by Cameron Abbasov.
Beautifully done. Check it out. Talk us through
Let's
this.
Let's look at the replay here. Cameron Abbasov was light on his feet the whole second round. Bounced right into an explosive right hand that hurts Okami, and then follows up with some left hands. Olivier Cost had to stop the bout. Okami was not intelligently defending himself anymore. Here's the right hand again. Okami got caught pulling his head back a little bit too high, and Abbasov finds that right hand at home. Great adjustments by Cameron Abbasov. Was a little bit flat-footed, a little bit hesitant in the first round, made the adjustments in the second round, light on his feet, powerful right hand, drops Okami and secures the victory for himself.
Let's go to Dominic Lau for the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 10 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Kiamrian Abbasov.
Prediction finished Nastyukhin inside of two rounds. Do not sleep on Timofey Nastyukhin. The man possesses some extraordinary power. But can he land on Alvarez here? For a chance in the semi-finals of the lightweight Grand Prix to meet Lowentainen. Lots of movement early on here from Nastyukhin.
Nastyukhin was able to connect with a nice little straight right hand. Let's wait for Eddie Alvarez to try to blitz in, throw those combinations, and then get out. When he blitzes in, that's going to be Nastyukhin's chance to land with that big right hand.
Punching right hand there from Nastyukhin. Got to be careful not to leave himself exposed when he overextends like that. Alvarez fakes the right hand. Controlling center cage here, the underground king. Looping left hand from Nastyukhin. Changing levels is Eddie. Just seeing what the Russian has to offer. Big outside leg kick from Alvarez. Not following through with that right hand there, Nastyukhin. Goes for the outside lead thigh of Alvarez. Alvarez circling off to his right. Chance go up for Eddie. They love him here in Japan. Made his name competing in Dream. Says he was super excited to return to the land of the rising sun. Nastyukhin's right hand cocked and ready.
Like the change in levels from Alvarez, he's immediately getting Nastyukhin to think about the takedown. If Nastyukhin gets comfortable, like he did with Amir Khan, like he did with Koji Ando, he's able to put together some brilliant performances. Eddie Alvarez needs to mix things up. He can't just stand there and strike with Nastyukhin. He's got to wrestle with him.
Alvarez outside back, straight right hand down the center there from Nastyukhin. And Alvarez smiles at him, but he felt that one.
Nice little catch to the right hand from Nastyukhin.
Perfectly placed catch and count. Another good right hand there from Timofey Nastyukhin. Alvarez not wanting to give up center cage here. Adding some little angles is the underground king. 2 minutes 45 remains. First round of three of this lightweight quarterfinal. Lots of instructions coming from the Russians in the corner of Nastyukhin.
Eddie Alvarez says he spent a lot of time working on his footwork and his speed for this match. He feels he's going to have the advantage in that area, the speed aspect.
Alvarez said that a punch would wobble Nastyukhin, and then he'd finish him with a submission. Nice right hand again from Timofey Nastyukhin on the upswing there with the uppercut, Eddie Alvarez. Some damage already under the right eye of Alvarez. Nothing too serious, though, for the Underground King. A punt kick there from him. Uppercut again from Alvarez. Back to center cage. Long reach on the right hand there from Eddie. Nastyukhin goes down the center corridor. Nice fancy footwork to get out of dodge from Alvarez. Goes to the body, kicked upstairs by the lead hand there from Nastyukhin. Quick release on the punches tonight from Timofey Nastyukhin. Usually loads them up a lot more, Nastyukhin, but he's chosen to go for speed and precision over a barrel full of power tonight.
You see, when Eddie Alvarez tries to get nice and tight, that's when Nastyukhin is able to land that right hand.
Alvarez fakes. Nastyukhin, good front kick, dug the balls of the air, feet into the midsection of Alvarez. That's what you want to do when you throw the front kick, splay the toes out, point the balls of the feet out and drive it into the stomach, into the chest of your opponent. Body shot there from Alvarez. Just over a minute remaining on Eddie Alvarez's one championship debut. A flipping left hand there from Nastyukhin, and tagged him. He tagged him with the underhand. Here comes Nastyukhin. We told you not to sleep on Nastyukhin. He's done it. Timofey Nastyukhin knocks out Eddie Alvarez.
Stunned. Timofey Nastyukhin just upset the Underground King. Would you call it an upset, Michael Cervello?
He told you not to sleep on Nastyukhin. There's a reason why he's got the word nasty in his name. He's a beast. He's a machine. He's now through to the semifinals. Timofey Nastyukhin shocks everyone here at the Rio Goku Koku Geekon, and here's how it happened.
Nastyukhin was able to close that distance, get Eddie Alvarez against the cage, and then it was the big right hand over the guard. I think Eddie blocked that, and Nastyukhin was still able to connect with that right hand. That is how much power Nastyukhin has in those punches. It is a dangerous game plan to stand and bang with Timofey Nastyukhin.
Look at the right hand, smack bang to the side of the head of Eddie Alvarez. Nastyukhin just unloading on a hapless Alvarez. These pulverizing fists, these jackhammer of hands. Eddie Alvarez is out for the lightweight Grand Prix. Nastyukhin will meet Lowen Tynanos in what will be an absolute grip snorter. Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 5 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Timofey Nastyukhin.